some satellite imagery that was taken by the UN of the wall. And the first thing that's come up there is the 1967 border, the green line. This is an area, the city is called Kalkilia. It's the city that is actually the closest to Tel Aviv and the closest to the sea. The city has a population, the city itself has a population of about 47,000, but on this map here, there's about 50,000 Palestinians who live in the area. You can see, well, here's where the wall goes up. Okay. You can see that in this area, that it actually has absolutely no relation to where the 1967 border is. It actually comes in very deep into the West Bank, into Palestinian territory. But there's a reason that it comes very deep in, which we'll see in just a second. Now, as I said, the population is about 50,000, number of villages in the area. They've all come up on the screen. And there are two settlements in the area. Okay. Zufin to the north, Al-Famanasha to the south. Together they have about a combined settler population of roughly 7,000. So 7,000 Israeli settlers, roughly 50,000 Palestinians living in this area. And you'll notice that the wall has actually comes to a close here in Kalkilia. That's actually correct. It does go around this entire area. It comes to a close just at that one little checkpoint there. There are Palestinians who live here in these areas as well. And I'll talk about them in just a second. Now, you'll see that where the wall has gone up is precisely feeding into this ideology, feeding into this idea of one being superior to the other, which is the wall is not going up on the 1967 border and also blocking in these people, but it's only going around the Palestinian areas and bringing in the settlement into Israel on the other side of the wall. So facilitating access for Israeli settlers while confining the Palestinians into small spaces. There are some gates that have been put in. These gates were put in largely at following some pressure that was brought to bear on Israel. There's a number of gates that are in the area, but you'll notice that some of them are marked as red, meaning no access for Palestinians, and some of them are marked as green, meaning restricted access for the Palestinians. What restricted access means for Palestinians is that you actually need to apply for a permit to be able to access your land on either side. It's not just, you know, you show up at the gate, they open up the gate and you go through. You actually have to apply for a permit from the Israeli authorities, and those permits are not always forthcoming. In fact, the majority of people who apply for permits are turned down, and only those Palestinians who actually own the land on the other side, so not the workers, but just the actual landowners, are allowed to apply for permits and able to get permits. But applying for permits is one thing. Actually getting the gates open is something else. And many times the gates are only open when they're open, twice a day, in the morning and in the afternoon. And but they're not always open. In fact, during the Jewish high holidays, the gates remain entirely closed. And what this has meant for Palestinians is that those Palestinians who wish to access their lands on the other side are unable to do so. This is important because this community is a farming community. It sits atop a water aquifer, and at one point in time provided about 50% of the produce for the Palestinians in the West Bank. With the closure of the gates, the inability to get permits, you can see what the effect has been, which is to completely separate Palestinians from their land. One of the things that's actually very interesting in this particular area is that there's an old law, actually an Ottoman law, that Israel exploits, still on the books. It's I like to call it the use it or lose it laws. And the use it or lose it laws basically state that if a person does not access his or her land for a period of 3 years, then the land can be reverted to the state. And if the land is reverted to the state, then more and more settlements are built. Now, what's happened with the imposition of the wall, the fact that permits are not issued, the fact that it's so difficult to access the land, is that Palestinians are very fearful that these use it or lose it laws are going to start kicking in very soon. And indeed, there's been a number of complaints that this is actually happening. Now, I want to do just a blow up of this one slide of Al-Famanasha, just so that you can see what's going on vis-a-vis the settlement activity. You'll notice that the settlement reside in the northern part of the settlement. But there's actually settlement expansion that is taking place in the south. So these are areas that have been cleared. And what you'll notice is that the wall doesn't just go up around the settlement, but it goes around the planned expansion areas of the settlement as well. So again, the idea is confine the Palestinians into small spaces and take as much of their land.